This book started with the doctoral research that I conducted when I was enrolled at the Pennsylvania State University. And it came from what I saw firsthand in 1990 when suddenly there was satellite television, there was a competition to Doordarshan, there was liberalization in television, and people were talking about programs such as The Bold and the Beautiful rather than Krishi Darshan, and you know. So it was a vast change that sort of crept into people's lives from overseas. So there were so many interesting things to look at, how this is affecting people's lives, our values getting affected, because there were lots of claims about cultural imperialism and so on. So I got actually very interested to kind of examine some of these changes that I witnessed firsthand, and to see whether the government, the run channel, Doordarshan, would itself be affected by these changes and to what degree. Actually, in terms of the sheer quantity of programming, we are definitely one of the leaders in Asia, if not in the globe. The sheer number of channels, and that goes for both entertainment and news. But in terms of news channels alone, we have definitely one of the largest news channel spaces in the world. So in terms of sheer numbers of hours of programming choice, of channels with different maybe ideological slants, the freedom that we enjoy is, I think, in many ways unparalleled, because it has preceded the regulation of it. I think regulation will catch up. In terms of content, unfortunately, although we have a lot of freedom in the media, we are constrained by commercial interests to some extent. And also, ethical standards, you can say, are not very high in certain aspects. But overall, I would be optimistic about the television space. You know, in compared to some countries, we have so much freedom, which is a huge plus. Change happens because of a number of reasons. One rather strange reason for liberalization in India as it occurred in the field of television was really the Gulf War. When the first Gulf War happened, people were watching the events unfolding via a primitive kind of cable system which was run in hotels. That was the start of, you know, India's cable industry. And from that very small beginning, we had cable run into localities, and then from there spread into throughout big towns and then smaller towns. So that was how people started watching satellite television in India. It was via the cable system, because the DBS and direct broadcast, the pizza sized dish that we see now is only about 2 or 3 years old in India. So things happen for a bunch of reasons. When satellite television, it was often called the invasion of the Indian skies. I don't know if it was the invasion, but it definitely did come from overseas, and the impetus was, I think Indian audiences were very hungry for entertainment and also news. They wanted a range of different programming which was then just not available on Doordarshan. You know, we can argue about the quality of news run on mainstream channels today, but I think the consumer is definitely happier in terms of getting more choice. The next question is, as a citizen, is the media, the broadcast media, doing its job? Well, probably not, because that is a more long-term thing. We need to see improvement in many areas. You can say that, you know, commercialization has meant that the audience has become consumers, but what has happened to the citizen? That is also a fair critique, I think. But overall, I think nobody would like to go back to the pre-1990 days where we had only Doordarshan. I don't think anybody would want to go in that direction.